In all my time spent adventuring in Dungeons & Dragons, I always seem to come across this question. Why aren't there more corpses or messes in dungeons? Sure, living creatures might dispose of bodies, but any place overrun by the dead wouldn't be bothered by more decay. As it turns out, D&D has its own garbage disposal system. Oozes. Welcome back to a Compendium of Monsters, it's Black Pudding Week. Before we continue, slap that subscribe button and stand way back. Seriously, this slightly more intelligent Roomba doesn't differentiate between the dead or living. Black puddings are challenge level 4, and you'll be in for a shock when it dissolves your gear. Black puddings have an armor class of 7, average hit points of 85, a speed of 20 feet, a climbing speed of 20 feet, and blindsight out to 60 feet, beyond which they are blind. Strangely, black puddings have no resistances to any forms of damage, which is fortunate because it's about to get much worse. Black puddings have immunity to acid damage, cold damage, lightning damage, slashing damage, and the following conditions: blinded, charmed, exhausted, frightened, and prone. Immunity to slashing damage for a challenge level 4 creature is just bonkers, but the condition immunities make sense. Black puddings have an intelligence score of 1, which is the lowest you can go without dying or being fully incapacitated. They're literally too stupid to be charmed or frightened. Black puddings have the amorphous ability, which allows them to travel inside a space as small as 1 inch wide without having to squeeze. That takes "they're coming out of the walls" to a whole new level of awful, doesn't it? Black puddings have corrosive form, which causes them to partially destroy melee weapons made of metal or wood and inflict a small amount of acid damage each time they are hit. While non-magical arrows are destroyed after impact, weapons take a -1 to their damage rolls until the penalty reaches a -5, after which the weapon is destroyed. I hope you brought extra weapons that don't deal slashing damage. What am I saying? Of course you didn't. To make matters worse, what, you didn't think I was done, did you? Black puddings can eat through non-magical metal or wood that is 2 inches thick in a single round. Here's Johnny! Last, black puddings have the spider climb ability, which allows them to climb difficult surfaces, including upside down on ceilings, without having to make an ability check. Spider pud. Leaps on targets from the roof. Actually, that's horrifying. I take it back. For their only action, black puddings have a single pseudopod attack, and they don't really need more than one. Each attack deals an average of 6 bludgeoning damage and 18 acid damage. Ordinarily, I'd make a crack that 24 average damage is low for a challenge level 4 creature, but there are a couple reasons I'd argue a black pudding's damage is actually way too high. For starters, pseudopod has an additional effect, corrosion. Yep, just in case you might have lost your weapon, you'll lose your armor too. Any creature wearing non-magical armor struck by a black pudding pseudopod takes a permanent -1 penalty to their armor class, and the armor is destroyed when its rating goes below 10. For their reaction, black puddings can split. No, not like run away or make a strange but somewhat tasty ice cream treat. I mean divide themselves into additional black puddings. Each time a black pudding takes slashing or lightning damage, it may split itself in half, shrinking by one size class and dividing its current hit points between the new forms. A black pudding may split a total of twice, ending up with 4 small black puddings, but the attack roll modifier and damage a black pudding deals remains the same. If we look at the absolute worst case scenario and the black pudding becomes 4 small puddings, the potential average damage suddenly becomes 96. 6 per round, which is absolutely TPK territory for a party of 4 level 4 adventurers. The only limitation for split is the black pudding must have at least 10 hit points in each new pair of puddings it creates. Thank goodness. How exactly oozes came to be is contested, but the most accepted theory is that they are spawn or fragments of the oozing hunger, the faceless lord, Jweeblet. Jweeblex is the only creature in existence that can control wild oozes or, in some rare cases, choose to bestow intelligence unto them. Sounds like a badly behaved uncle influencing children at a family reunion, but with extra steps. As is the case with most Monster Manual entries, there are some issues with black puddings. Specifically, an ooze kills its prey slowly. Some varieties, such as black puddings and gelatinous cubes, engulf creatures to prevent escape. Show me where a black pudding can engulf its target. It's almost as if people don't read the monster stats before just assigning random descriptions. The next bit is something I find funny because of what it implies.
Since not every ooze digests every type of substance, some have coins, metal gear, bones, and other debris suspended within their quivering bodies.
Ooh, quivering? How exciting!
A slain ooze can be a rich source of treasure for its killers.
So what you're telling me is that I could have been rewarded for slaying this f***ing asshole ooze that goes around destroying valuable weapons and armor, but because it digests everything, I get bupkis? Kindly f*** right out of here with that s*** and find someone else to deal with your black pudding problem. DMs, Run a black pudding when you need a break from planning intelligent combat and you want to demoralize your players by breaking their presumably expensive gear. But seriously, I use mouth breather as an insult, but to call a black pudding a mouth breather is a compliment. With an intelligence score of 1 and a wisdom score of 6, you'd be hard-pressed to find a stupider creature. Even though black puddings have a blindsight limitation, your player's character's attacks against it only encourage the black pudding to dash in the direction of attacks, hoping to secure its next meal. Black puddings are not intelligent enough to flee when they are near death and generally attack the closest creature. Be sure to describe how your player's character's weapons and armor degrade as they attack and get attacked by the black pudding. They may just sit there and slug it out with the black pudding, or they may change tactics and try to kite the pudding, who will absolutely take the bait. There are a few things that I make sure happen before the fight begins. First, the dungeon floor and low walls are described as abnormally clean. No dust, no grime, nothing. Second, there is a notable absence of other creatures anywhere the black pudding typically travels. The remaining creatures in the dungeon should be smart enough to stay out of the pudding's way and take care not to cross paths with it. And last, the black pudding always starts from an ambush position. If you have your black pudding hiding in a wall, you don't necessarily have to roll a stealth check for it unless your players obsessively peer into cracks in the walls. In that case, just have the black pudding roll an attack with advantage as it pours out of the wall in a horrifying fashion. Happy birthday! Wait, wrong celebration. If you have a dwarf player who likes to lick stone walls for fun, I'm not saying do this to them specifically, but I'm not saying it either. Players! Sounds like you have a sticky situation on your hands, or gear, but whatever, it's not like I have to pay your repair bill. Black puddings don't typically appear more than once in a dungeon, but you really need to conserve your gear. The best way to kill a black pudding is to attack it from range, though be aware your DM might be watching you for metagaming if this is your first encounter with an ooze. If you're a slash-happy martial melee class and suddenly won't go toe-to-toe with a black pudding at the start of the encounter, way to go! Super awesome. Obvious metagaming. Did you know some oozes have a vacuum attack that pulls you into melee range? Exactly! Now, don't cry about your trashed gear, because the mending spell is exactly what you need to solve that problem! Just kidding, you're f***ed. Rules as written, the mending spell repairs specifically breaks or tears, no larger than 1 foot in any dimension. This does not apply to chemical damage from corrosive ooze. This is a very long-winded way of saying, get into melee range, take your lick, get out of range, and try not to screw yourself for the rest of the dungeon. Some parting thoughts. If your DM has the pudding behave unpredictably, you have a serious problem on your hands. Oozes are stupid enough to chase you until you or it die, which allows you to attack it from range while you run away. But if the pudding suddenly hides behind a wall or moves through a wall to better reach you without taking hits, I'd call it common sense that a creature without a visible brain is unlikely to use advanced combat tactics, and you deserve to know the truth. Dweeblex is definitely involved, and you should run. Preferably the entire encounter ago, but now will suffice. Anyways, what do you all think of black puddings? Let me know in the comments below. A special thank you to my patrons. And thank you all so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please hit that subscribe button, smash that like button, share my video on your Twitter, Facebook, or other social media, and make the leap to become one of my patrons on Patreon. I'll see you all next time.